Hello everyone, in this video we're looking at factorising more difficult quadratics, and you'll see here that in the middle I've got some instructions that we can follow for these particular quadratic equations. And we use this method when we have something like this, where we've got a non-1 coefficient in front, and it's not immediately obvious that we can factorise it any other way. So you can see that 4 does not go into 11 or 6, and so we can't factorise it in that method. So I'll let you read this method at your own time. You can pause and read it if you want, but I'm going to go through this example while reading it. So it starts by saying, recall that a quadratic can be written as ax squared plus bx plus c. So that simply means for this example that a would be 4, b would be 11, and c would be 6. It says, look for two numbers that multiply to ac. So ac would be 24. And add to B. So I've got to try and come up with two numbers that multiply to 24 but add to 11. So let's look at all the factors of 24. So we've got 4 and 6 already, which it obviously isn't. We've got 2 and 12. We've got 24 and 1. We also have 8 and 3, and of course 8 and 3 add to 11, so those are going to be our two numbers, so P and Q. So P equals 3 and Q equals 8. So in our next step, it tells us to write it as AX squared plus PX plus QX plus C. So we're going to write our original equation. Instead of 11X, we're going to write 3X plus 8X plus 6. And so you can see that 3x plus 8x is still equal to 11x, so we haven't changed the equation, we've merely written it in a different form. So for our next step, we are going to factorise this in two stages. And so this is what we were doing a couple of videos ago. We're going to look at this bit here, so we're going to write that as x bracket 4x plus 3, and then we're going to do the same with this part here. So we'll take out a common factor of 2, and so we can write it as 4x plus 3. And now we can see that we've got that same bracket of 4x plus 3 occurring twice, so that now becomes our common factor. So we're going to write that out the front, 4x plus 3, and then multiply with the other parts times in those brackets, x and 2, so we've got x plus 2, and now that is fully factorised. That's our final answer. So a slightly convoluted process, but it can make it a lot quicker to factorise and solve a quadratic this way than, say, using the quadratic formula or completing the square, which we will look on at later on. So let's quickly look at one more example and apply this method. So here, a equals 12, b equals 1, and c equals negative 6. So ac equals negative 72. So we're looking for two numbers that times to negative 72 but add to negative 1, or sorry, to positive 1. So that would be positive 9 and negative 8. So we're going to write this out again, but we're going to write it as 12x squared plus 9x minus 8x minus 6. And so writing out our factors, we'll have 3x bracket 4x plus 3 minus, and we'll take out a common factor of 2 here, and then we'll have 4x plus 3 again. So you can see that we have this 4x plus 3 bracket occurring twice, so we'll write that out the front, 4x plus 3, and then in the next bracket we'll have 3x minus 2. And so now it is fully factorised. So this method is quite reliable and it makes it easy to factorise these two brackets. And I'll get you to go have a look at 15.05. Thank you.